The entire Saudi royal family is estimated to be worth $1.4 trillion. And Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman might be the most lavish spender of them all. He controls part of the royal family's vast wealth, but he also has a personal wealth of $12.5 billion. He essentially runs the country for his father and has used his royal wealth to buy some pretty extravagant things, like gold sports cars and a $450 million Leonardo da Vinci painting. From $100 million vacations to high-tech super yachts, here's everything the Crown Prince of one of the world's richest families spends his money on. While Prince Salman is not the official ruler of Saudi Arabia, he's the one calling the shots from behind the throne. Which also means he has access to billions of dollars, and he's developed a reputation for spending a lot of it. One of his biggest purchases is a $300 million French chateau, which was once the most expensive home in the world. Officially named Chateau Louis XIV, the mega mansion is located near Versailles and stuns onlookers with its marble statues, hedged labyrinth, and 57-acre landscaped yard. While the residence is kept as private as possible, it has attracted notable celebrity visitors, mainly because of its moat, which is a giant transparent underwater chamber with lots of sturgeon and koi swimming around. The home also features a wine cellar, movie theater, and a rotunda with an exquisite fresco on the ceiling. While the home might be very 17th century in style, inside there are tons of modern high-tech features, like fountains, a sound system, lights, and ultra-silent air conditioning that can all be controlled remotely with an iPhone or iPad. The official ownership of the chateau is carefully shrouded by shell companies in France and Luxembourg. Those companies are owned by 8 Investment Company, a Saudi firm managed by the Crown Prince's personal foundation. The prince also has access to tons of apartments in desirable cities. His father owns a dozen apartments in the most affluent region of Paris. They're worth an estimated $35 million altogether. And of course, we can't forget about the multiple royal palaces, including the famous al-Yamama Palace, where both the king and the prince have met with leaders from all over the world. Another amazing palace owned by the crown is the mesmerizing Royal State Palace. The royal family also has permanent suites available at luxury hotels all over Jeddah. They're paid for year-round by the Saudi government, so the royals have no shortage of luxury accommodations. For some reason, royals all around the world seem to have a thing for gold vehicles, as ugly as they are. Well, Prince Salman is no exception to this trend. His collection of luxury vehicles includes a gold Lamborghini Aventador, worth $7.5 million, a gold Bentley Continental Flying Spur, worth $6.5 million, a gold Rolls-Royce Phantom Coupe, estimated to be worth about $8 million. An impressively unique gold Mercedes AMG G63 6x6 truck worth $4 million. But the best and most expensive, best in quotations, gold vehicle he currently owns is a gold Bugatti Veyron, worth $12.5 million, of which there are only 17 gold models in the entire world. Rounding out the prince's collection are a Mercedes S600 Guard, worth $1.4 million, and his most modest car, a Range Rover Sentinel, worth $500,000. But the prince's luxury models of transportation don't end there. He owns a $500 million super yacht named Serene. The 440-foot-long yacht is currently the 15th largest yacht in the world, and it has not one, but two helipads. There are also 3 swimming pools, a super-sized hot tub, a sauna, a fully equipped spa, too. There are multiple bars, including one right beside the hot tub, and of course they're fully stocked at all times. To keep the prince and his guests entertained while at sea, the massive boat even has its very own indoor rock climbing wall. The Saudi royal family also owns multiple private Boeing 747-400 passenger jets worth over $100 million each. The planes have huge meeting rooms featuring a lot of gold accents, and some of them even have throne rooms. Throne rooms. The family also owns some custom Boeing 767s worth $185 million each. They feature huge master bedrooms and 63 seats. There are 7 televisions in each plane, and they offer the prince and his entourage 1,066 square feet of cabin space. Sure, the planes are expensive to buy, but they're also super expensive to keep in the air. They cost as much as $30,000 an hour to operate. While Salman was an ambassador for the United States, it's reported he spent over $8 million on travel between the U.S. and Saudi Arabia. Another huge perk of being a member of one of the world's richest families is the amount of rare, one-of-a-kind things you have the money to buy. Prince Salman has definitely enjoyed putting his money to good use by collecting rare artwork. He spent $450 million for Leonardo da Vinci Vinci's painting Salvator Mundi at an auction that required a $100 million deposit just to qualify for bidding. The 500-year-old painting was rumored to have been displayed on his yacht not long after he bought it. Well, of course, he bought it, he wants to enjoy it. What do you want? It's also rumored that the prince was the one behind the purchase of a 432,000 Hermes bag. The Himalayan crocodile Birkin bag was sold to an unspecified member of the Saudi royal family, but the prince has the biggest reputation for buying expensive luxury items. The lavish bag features Nilo crocodile and is meant to evoke images of the majestic Himalayan mountains. It has 18-karat white gold hardware studded with white diamonds. Another reputation the royal family has developed? Loving lavish vacations. The royal family has a vacation home in Cannes, an historic villa that has hosted many celebrities and political figures, like Sir Winston Churchill. It was officially bought by the royal family in 1979. Whenever the family visits now, the government completely shuts down the nearby beach so they can have private access. And that's not the only luxe vacation the royal family splurges on. The king also has spent over $100 million on a Moroccan vacation. He apparently traveled with 1,000 guests, who were mostly booked in luxury hotels in the area, while the king stayed at his 74-acre summer palace, which has helipads and private beach access. The month-long trip is estimated to have cost about 1.5% of Morocco's annual foreign tourism revenue in 2017. In case you were wondering, the king and the crown prince also reportedly spent more than $30 million renting out villas in the Maldives. They booked three entire resorts for an entire month, causing backlash when guests had their reservations canceled at the last minute. So how did the Saudi royal family become worth more than $1 trillion? Well, most of the royal family's wealth is thanks to the enormous reserves of petroleum discovered in Saudi Arabia more than 75 years ago. Oil producer Saudi Aramco is the most valuable company in the world and earned $68 billion in the first 9 months of 2019 alone. The company's value passed $2 trillion after share prices soared in March of 2020. Royal family members also get paid for being royals, which definitely helps them stay wealthy. They're all given stipends, ranging up from $270,000 a month for a son of the founding king to $8,000 a month for his great-great-grandchildren. Bonuses of $1 million to $3 million have been given to some royals as wedding gifts to help start construction on their new palaces. The Saudi royal family also has spent a lot of money gaining control of all the royal assets and investments. Records leaked from a Bermuda law firm known as the Paradise Papers revealed how groups of lawyers, bankers, and accountants quickly transferred ownership of properties and assets to the Aid Investment Company. The price of these transfers was $494 million in today's dollars, and the Crown Prince owns most of his property under this company. People have definitely criticized the Saudi royal family and the Crown Prince for being shady in their transactions and spending more money than they make public. It's likely that they own plenty more property around the world than no one even knows about. It's all very well hidden thanks to many of their shell and investment companies, but there's no doubt that Prince Salman, King Salman, and the entire royal family are making most of their wealth while they can, whether it's gold cars, super yachts, or the occasional priceless painting. The Saudi royal family might be swimming in money, but even they can't buy everything they want. In 2020, the Crown Prince was trying to buy Newcastle United Football Club for $381 million, but eventually had to remove his bid, though he apparently still has interest in owning his own major sports team. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe for more.